Liz Brown. Liz Brown. Call the operator, please. Liz Brown.
Sorry, miss. Have a seat over here.
Paging any janitor. We need a janitor in our children's unit. I repeat, we need a janitor in our children's unit. But I have a few announcements to make. There will be an administrative staff meeting in room 204 at 4:30 today. All administrators and their immediate assistants are advised to attend. There have been many of you truant to these meetings recently. The meetings are short, and they will keep you advised in administrative matters that are necessary for you to do a good job. The deadline for ticket sales for the upcoming parental fundraiser is Friday. All tickets must be sold or turned in. One final announcement, you get back to work. Flu shots will be available free to you and your family on Thursday from 1 to 3 p.m. in each week. Drink strong beer and choose a guest and for your own sake. It is a new serum that, contrary to those rumors, won't make you sick. Our policy is not to allow you to stay unless you get the inoculation. Of course, it's up to you.
Grunty, here's another mother.
Be seated, please.
Call me when you're finished with her, Mrs. Broden.
Before we set up counseling times for your specific problems, I have a couple of paper items for you. Here is our brochure and our...
Mr. Cord, paging Mr. Cord. Mrs. Broughton needs your help. If you will kindly go to her office immediately.
Thank you.
please. This was scratch your ears. Scratch, scratch. Karen, do you realize it's time for you to do the dishes, dear? There are 3 days worth waiting for you in the kitchen.
Mother, in 2 weeks I'll be out of school. The pressures are intense. And even though I met Robert a week ago, I'm in love with him. I may marry him. I don't know what I'll do with my future. A lot is on my mind, Mother. Besides, I didn't dirty them all. You're a whore.
The famous prep school that Churchill had attended as a boy. Ask Mr. Churchill to address the students. The headmaster told the young people to bring their pencils and their notebooks to record what Britain's greatest man of the century would say. The moment they had waited for came, the old man stood to his feet and spoke these words. Never give in. Never give in.
Don't you think it's time for you to do your homework? You know your last report card was shit. Mother, you just don't understand. School is just no good for me now. Timmy. I think I need more out of life. But you've got to do it. You're only in the second grade.
Okay, okay.
It seems like we never get to see each other anymore. Why don't we ever do anything together, Mom?
Now, Timmy, I know your tricks. The only thing I can tell you at this time is that if we're good, we'll have lots of time in heaven together. But now it's time to study.
...are found throughout the Declaration of Independence. Most presidents of the United States have declared their faith.
Now, Theo, I've asked you several times to rid this house of those rodents that live here, and as of yet, you have failed. What seems to be the problem? I really think we should sit down and talk it over.
I become quite fond of little creatures. We had many for friends in France. They keep me company while everybody's away, and they're nice.
What?
I become quite fond of little creatures. We had many for friends in France. They keep me company while everybody's away, and they're nice.
Leo, do you realize that that's the same excuse the children used last year when they wanted to keep all those rabbits? They were just too much trouble, and what did they have to finally do? Do you ever think you'll have another love affair, Gloria? The closest you ever came was when you were 16. And your mother fixed you with that one. which found you in the hallway. Your sweater was open, and his pants were down. Will you ever forget what she said?
Say something. Come on. Say something. Come on, Amy. Now stay here. Now sit down. Come on. Now stay here with me. Come on. And don't go on. Nice, pussycat.
We have a Statue of Liberty on the East Coast. May we now erect on the West Coast, either physically or symbolically, another statue. The Statue of Responsibility. In order to remind America in between the two statues that we have no rights in this country without corresponding duties.
You cute little things. You cute little things. You go off and play now. You go off and play. Hi, Timmy.
Hi, Uncle Veal.
Oh. Dum 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 dum. Look at those itty bitty legs.
One that he gives us whether we are good or not. May we be gathered. And may America understand that our national symbol is not the clenched fist, which stands for hatred, for violence, and for destruction. America's symbol from now on must be the folded hands. The folded hands that stand for prayer. A carnal decade in order that he may bless America. God love you.
Oh, I see. Just a moment. She's in the kitchen. She won't be able to come to the phone at the moment. I can have her call you when she's finished.
Yes, that would be fine. Maybe you and I could have lunch together.
Now she'll just have to learn to live with you, my little friends. Itty bitty bitty bye.
Nice pussycat, go to sleep.
again. I never wanted to, but what am I to do? I can't help it. Love's always been my game.